And finally tonight, a very unusual window on events in Iran. In Tehran today, the state prosecutor announced that authorities have cut all outside contact with the country's two senior opposition leaders, Mir Hussein Mousavi, the former presidential candidate, and Mahdi Karoubi, had been under house arrest after urging supporters to attend rallies several weeks ago. Their whereabouts now are unknown. All of these developments are being closely watched by two young men here in Washington who've become stars in Iran. Welcome to the world of Parazit, a weekly mix of Western attitude and Persian culture and humor, often zany and satirical, sometimes straightforward and serious. Here, the news about Iran is most definitely not what its government puts out. And Iranian President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad can be, well, the funniest guy on the planet.
What is it to you?
Liar! As soon as this guy opens his mouth, we have a material to work with because he doesn't make sense whatsoever.
And so each week, 35-year-old Kambiz Husseini, who came to the U.S. a decade ago, and Saman Arbabi, 37, who arrived when he was in middle school, try to make their own kind of sense, broadcasting to Iran in Farsi as part of the U.S. government-funded Persian News Network at the Voice of America headquarters in Washington, D.C.
Frankly, we did something new, I think. 99.9.9% of the news that comes out of Iran is bitter. You know, there's nothing fun. It's always something horrible. And reporting the news has been repetitive. So we turn it into how we would talk about it, as if we're talking to you right now, or we're sitting at a bar.
Right, this is it.
Indeed, Parazit, which translates to static, a reference to the Iranian government's repeated attempts to jam foreign satellite programming and websites, often takes the "Are you kidding me?" approach. As when Supreme Leader Ayatollah Khamenei recently claimed that Egypt's uprising was a reprise of Iran's Islamist revolution. Parazit played the tape.
Today in Egypt, the echo of your voice is heard.
And host Kambiz Husseini responded.
Says who? Who has said that? Who told you? Where have you heard it?
The point, Husseini says, is that leaders can and should be questioned.
They want people to believe that this is not their voice, this is the voice of God. And you have to believe it, not because I say it, because this is bigger than life and bigger than this world of ours. What we're trying to do is we humanize these people,
right,
for people of Iran, saying, look, watch, listen. These people are human, just human, like us, and they can make mistakes, and you are entitled to question them. They're not prophets.
Kambiz.
Now in its second season, Parazit features several segments, some out of the John Stewart playbook, like faux reporting in the field. And there are interviews, sometimes straight, sometimes for laughs. Recent events in Egypt gave the Parazit pair a chance to point out a few differences between the countries with a big wink of the eye.
People of Iran, do you know what has happened in Egypt? There is an uprising there, a revolution. They are going to open bars. Women don't have to wear veils anymore. High-speed internet is becoming available.
In other words, not so bad.
Dude.
The surprise result, this creation of two self-described regular dudes, has become one of the most popular programs in Iran, where it's watched on satellite TV, illegal but widely used, and on internet sites such as Facebook, which is also illegal, but where the program had close to 30 million views in the past month. The show is a hit with the Iranian-American community as well. Mehran, a math teacher who doesn't want to share his last name for fear of reprisal to his mother in Iran, and Faraday Soltani, an IT specialist, get together every Friday evening in McLean, Virginia, to watch.
I also like their kind of anti-censorship spirit that they bring. It's humorous. What's taking place in Iran and the ruling ideology in Iran is very somber. So comedy, satire, and all that really puts a wonderful spin to what's going on in Iran.
When I see Parazit posted on Facebook via my friends and relatives, distant relatives in Iran, that it's, you know, you get this sense that, oh, all of us like this show. And so, yes, it somehow brings you together.
From Iran, Soltani's cousin responded to our question about why she values Parazit.
When Kambiz talks, you feel that you have just seen him in the street. The same jokes and same preoccupations as those of today's youth in Iran. What matters to us is important to him, too.
In fact, more than half of Iran's population is below the age of 30. And playing to them, using their phrases and slang, is clearly part of Parazit's success. Still, there are some topics that remain off-limits, most of all, religion. And there are plenty of times when Parazit plays it straight and serious, as in a recent interview with a blogger who'd escaped Iran.
Were you tortured?
Yes, I was.
How?
Physically.
Also not funny, the latest crackdown by the government on demonstrators who took to Tehran's streets after Egypt's successful uprising. Husseini and Arbabi dedicated that week's program to two young men killed during the protests. One of them, Mohammed Mokhtari, was a fan of Parazit and had shared the latest show on his Facebook wall just 2 days before his death. All of this, of course, raises the question, how much is Parazit out to change the world? Here are Bobby demurs.
We're nobodies. We're a bunch of people in front of TV just saying the same stuff that people hear all about. We just do it in a different way under the umbrella of humor. But it's for the audience to decide for themselves, you know, whether they like us or they don't like us. A lot of people have come together from many sides of the opposition groups, including even the government, and they watch the show. Now, if they choose to change their mind and see things a little bit differently, that's up to them.
Democracy. Democracy.
In fact, the government has taken notice, even producing its own state-run anti-Parazit program that uses similar techniques, sometimes even clips from the show itself, while reminding viewers that Parazit is supported by the U.S. government and branding its two creators spies. Husseini and Arbabi, who are both U.S. citizens and federal employees, seem to enjoy the backhanded homage to their work.
It's turned into a war of comedy. So we do a show that's, around humor, and they try to counter us with another funny show.
You think they're listening? You think they're watching, huh?
I'm sure they watch this show and say, damn, they're good. You know,
this is The Daily Show with...
And apparently Jon Stewart thinks they're damn good, too. He saluted the pair in a recent Daily Show appearance.
I can see the passion in what you do, and it's very engaging. When you watch the show, you feel like the heart and the anger, and then they constantly cut away to some, to like for the comedy break.
I'm the funny dude.
No!
Would you like to do this program in Iran?
We'd love to.
With audience and all that?
Absolutely. Yeah. Live audience, the whole shebang. It'd be one of our dreams come true.
That's a very great moment for me and Salman to do this, because doing this show from Iran, meaning that country already becomes democratic and they can tolerate a show like this in their media, criticizing their own government.
But if you went now, impossible now.
Now, impossible.
Oh, we can go.
You can go.
We just wouldn't come back.
And so, for now, Parazit will continue to push the limits of Tehran's tolerance from thousands of miles away.